Hi all, welcome back to my channel IT Pro Teams. Today we will continue with our last video. In that, we have seen a demonstration of Microsoft 365 backup service, how to enable it, how to create the resource group and subscription in Azure, how to go and enable it. Post enabling, how basically we can create the policy and add the resource for the backup. Today, this will be a short video, and this video I will show you if you have taken a backup of any resource with Office 365 backup service, then how you're going to restore that backup. So, in my previous video, let me go to the service. And we go here under the exchange, and then you can see we have a backup which currently show you green. And if you want to see how many mailboxes are included in this backup, currently there are two mailboxes included in this backup. So if you click on view details, then you will able to see right what all are the two mailboxes right included in this particular scope. So I have included two mailboxes. One is for my administrator, second is for Alex. Okay. Now let's see if how we are going to restore the deleted items right from that particular backup. So first we go to Alex mailbox and we'll see there are certain mails in the Alex mailbox with the date, right? Some notifications, right? So one or two. So you can see this is on your behalf. This is the email behalf of your organizations. The date is 1/17, right? That means 17 Jan. And this one is on 14 Jan, right? These are the two mails. Let's go and select these two mails and let them delete. Can go and delete them. So now the mails deleted, right? We'll go to the deleted items. We again select those two mails and we can empty this folder. So definitely, if you deleted it from here, it will go to your recover deleted items. You go to the recover deleted items and you select it and you can delete it from here as well. So now those two emails are not in the deleted items, not even in the recoverable deleted items. So they are permanently deleted from this particular mailbox of Alex. Now, as I already told you, this mailbox under the backup of Microsoft 365 backup services. So that means we can try to restore those two deleted emails, right? Let's see, we don't see any mail, right? For 14 and 17, we only see it here 6 and 3. So let's go to the backup service. Then you can see this option here under that restore. You click on this restore icon, then it will ask you which kind of content you want to restore, right? Definitely, we are going to restore the Exchange mailbox because we have only enabled the backup for Exchange Online. Click Next. Now it will ask you which user mailbox you want to restore. So you click here, it will show you the list of the mailboxes which are the part of your scope. So what we are going to choose, we are going to select Alex mailbox here because we deleted the mail from Alex mailbox. So now click on Next. Once you do that, then it will show you there are two options in the restore all the emails that you want to restore for that particular user, or you want to restore the selected. So definitely I don't want to restore everything. So what I'm going to do, select the content only, right? And now here I can choose the duration. Last 24 hours, or might be 48 hours, or might be 7 days, might be 14 days. Let's go with the 14 days. Then we have to add a features, right? So do I know what was the keyword of that particular attachment? The mail coming from or mail to, we know the mail is coming to Alex. So we can type Alex. It automatically show you the mailbox of Alex, right? Now, if you go down here, it will ask you find the matching items. If you click here, then whatever the mails which are coming in last 14 days for the Alex, it will show you here. So currently there are total 7 items, right? You can see there are 7 items available here, right? You can click next. Then it is an option. Do you want to restore it in the same folder or you want to restore into a new folder? I want to make sure I'm going to restore into a new folder because I want the user to know the restore is done right from the backup service. And what it will do, it will go and create a folder called recovered items with the year, month, date, hours, time. So click next. So now total 7 items, which including our 2 item also, right? Because I was not aware the heading of the mail. So that's the reason I'm taking it last 14 days, right? And this will be the folder. Click restore user mailbox. Let's wait for this task to create and complete. So restoration task is created. You click on done. Once you do it, right, then under the restoration task, you'll see there is one active task, right? Then once this active task will go to restore, that means the restoration is done. Based on my experience, this service is not very fast, but not very slow as well. When you are restoring it, it's a small number, right? You'll able to see the progress here, right? Okay. In the progress, once it will be completed, it will give you in the logs, you'll able to see the status. And here you can see the current status is in progress. So we have to wait for some time, right? And here you can see the further details, right? What type of content, mailbox, status, who initiated this restore request as well. So you go here, even you can see your limit also, right? So how many restore requests we can able to create at the same time? So Microsoft only allow 25 restore requests at the same time, right? Now the next questions, user mailbox is being restored in active restore task. How many mailboxes you can able to restore in those, right? The task itself. So we can create 25 restore requests, and one restore request can including maximum of 1000 mailboxes, right? The maximum number of user mailboxes that you can able to restore, right, is the 10,000. So this is the limit of restoring the data from Microsoft 365 backup service. There will be some improvement in this particular service because currently it's in preview. So once Microsoft will fully flash launch this product, there is a lots of scope of improvement, right? Now we can only see it via GUI, right? So we are not able to see the items. We are not able to choose the items going like, because now I won't remember the name of that particular or the header of that particular email which I have to restore, right? So that's the reason I have to restore the entire data itself. But if I have to select a particular email, that part is missing from this Microsoft 365 backup service. Other 365 tools are giving you that option, but it's not given by Microsoft. So we just need to wait for to complete this restore request, and once it will be done, I will show you the items in the user. Yeah, here you can see this one is completed. Now we can go to the user mailbox and we have to refresh it. Once you go to the user mailbox and refresh it, you will not able to see the item here. As you remember, when we done the restore request, I told it has to create a new folder and all the restore items should be there in that folder. So if you can see here, there's a new folder is created in the user and with the date and the timestamp, right? And under that folder, if you click, then you'll able to see there's a folder created, and under that folder you'll able to see all the items, right? So these 17 and 14 items are included. There are other item also, because I was not able to do the filter, but if we can write a more correct filter, we'll able to restore based on the header or the content type or recipient. But I restore it for the entire inbox, which included these mails, which might be already existed in the user inbox, right? If you can go and see it here. But that's how you can able to perform the restore from the Microsoft Backup Service. And this is the complete status. This is for, that's the end of the video. Guys, please like and subscribe my channel for more this kind of videos. Thank you.